again. Today we're talking to CEO of Tlou Energy, Tony Gilby. Tony, welcome. You've been awarded a new mining license for your project in Botswana. A bit of a relief that that's come through finally. How difficult was that to get?
Good morning, Polly, and glad to be here again. The award of a mining license is a very significant milestone for the company. It's something we've been working on for quite a considerable period of time. The primary input to a mining license is an approval for an environmental impact statement. Now, that environmental impact statement took us approximately 2 years to achieve, and then after completion of the environmental impact statement, we pulled together a submission for a mining license, which included economic modelling and also a feasibility study. We lodged all of that documentation a few short weeks ago, and it went according to plan. The government accepted our mining license application and awarded it. So we were very pleased with that outcome. It is effectively the first mining license in the entire country for coalbed methane and natural gas. So we're very, very pleased with that outcome and puts us even further ahead of the competition.
Just to pick up on that environmental point, if I may, Tony, for a second, there was a lot of opposition, after all, to this licence being granted. But as you say, the environmental proposals within your appraisal and the report that you submitted, comprehensive. Do you anticipate that those concerns will go away now, or is there a possibility they could still hold you up?
I'm not aware of any environmental concerns, actually, Polly. The process went very smoothly. We consulted widely with the local population. We followed all of the regulations, all of the requirements in terms of base level studies, in terms of archaeology, in terms of land use, in terms of water use. And we ticked all those boxes after a lot of hard work and expenditure. It was a very in-depth, a thorough process, and the environmental report was done to the highest world standards. So we indeed ticked all the boxes, and in the public consultation period, I'm not aware of any significant negativity that came back. So the process and the consultation worked extremely well.
Tell us a little bit then about the area itself and what happens next.
Well, with the award of a mining license, that gives a security of tenure for a considerable period of time. We're still waiting on the actual details of it, and once they're received by the company, we will, as always, announce that and put out a release to update the market. But it effectively quarantines the area that has been awarded from relinquishment for many years. It moves the project from the exploration stage to the development stage, and that is indeed why it's such a major milestone. The government, in awarding of the mining license, considers the project to be ready for commercial production. So indeed, that's very important. The award of the mining license was very fortuitous in timing, and the lodgement and the hard work has paid off, because the award has been prior to the submission of the response to proposal for a 100 megawatt process, which is going on right now. In fact, that 100 megawatt response or proposal was due yesterday, and we went in to lodge that with the mining license box ticked as well. And right at the point of lodgement, we were informed by the government that they had extended that process by another month through to approximately the 20th or through to the 20th of September. And that was to accommodate a request of the other bidding party.
So tell us how the share price has responded to this new license being granted.
Well, it was received in a very positive manner. Of course, being CEO, I would have hoped and anticipated that it would have been received in an even more enthusiastic manner, but it helped to underpin our current share price and provide a good foundation for additional and future growth. So it's just such a major milestone reached and puts us in a very, very strong position for further growth. I think the market is looking for additional milestones to be reached as well, and rest assured we're working hard to achieve those, and our process has been a steady one of slowly but surely reducing the risk of the project such that at a certain point in time the investment thesis will become compelling for even a much wider investment community, and the share price should then respond accordingly.
And this, Tony, the first push for a commercial gas-to-power project in Botswana, and very good for people locally too, in terms of both investment in the local community and, of course, employment.
Well, absolutely, and that will form a key component of our response to proposal for the 100-megawatt project. The primary objective is to initially get into the grid with a lower capex, circa 10 megawatts, and then expand from there. And the part of the process is to point out the employment opportunities, the fact that it creates a whole new industry. It means that the government will not be needing to purchase expensive imported diesel and power from primarily South Africa. So it's a balance of payment issue as well for the country. And it also supports and underpins a viable renewable energy, particularly a solar industry. Botswana has a lot of sunshine and therefore should be very good for a solar industry. What it does lack is good base load to underpin that solar industry. Good clean base load and gas will play a critical role there. And I think Tlou gas will play that critical role for the benefit of both our shareholders and the Botswanan people.
And how confident are you about this other proposal that you have in the pipeline that is due to be submitted soon? What are you thinking will be the result on that?
Well, we've worked very hard on it. We've had a team of very experienced consultants advising us and working on the bankable feasibility study. We've had a high-level people with worldwide experience as part of our team in terms of the engineering, the design, and who are associated with us in terms of the implementation of the power lines and the gas generating system. So I'm very confident we'll have a very compelling proposal, and of course it should be looked upon favourably, I'm sure, given the fact that we initially initiated the process of a pilot, a gas-to-power project to get some gas converted to electricity and then into the grid in Botswana. So we initiated that process some time ago. It's now developed into a formal request for proposal from ourselves and another tenderer. The process is therefore a competitive tender. And indeed, we're not afraid of competition. We welcome it because there is an enormous energy shortfall in Botswana and surrounding countries. So there's plenty for everyone. I guess what's particularly good for our shareholders at the moment is that we're the only ones with a full environmental approval for upstream. We're the only ones with independently certified gas reserves. We're the only ones with a project that has now been using our own gas to convert to electricity and generating electricity on site now for a number of weeks, and that's ongoing. So we're in a very strong position, Paul.
Well, Tony, good luck with the project. Great to talk to you. Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you very much.